Thank you very much for giving me a very big opportunity to express my opinion and talk about the issues of society and education. This is my biggest honor and happiness. You may write and the speech title, Where the Dragon to Fly. And so, I start my speech with an introduction to generative artificial intelligence, called that generative AI or Gen AI. As you knew, generative AI is being the hot topic, especially there are some miracle applications such as ChatGPT and Bard. There are two main applications of generative AI. Generative AI models are incorporated into natural language processing, which applies a so-called larger language model aims to generate human understandable content like ChatGPT. Generative AI model aims to generate digital content like sound image. Both models apply deep neural network into generating text. This speech mentioned the generative model for digital content generation called the digital generative AI model, whose taxonomy is listed in the next slide. Such models aim to generate the Dragon's orbit, as mentioned in the speech title. And this is the taxonomy of the generative models. And there are two main kinds of the digital generative models. This is the explicit density and implicit density. There are explicit density and implicit density. Explicit density is mean that the probability density function of the of the generative models is specified explicit, and implicit density model it mean that the density function is not specify explicit, but it's implicit, and this is two approach for explicit density, but this is in the approximate density function, the versional autoencoders is very important. And yes, this is very important. And in this model, there are two, there are the unencoder and decoder. And encoder is encoding the data, the originator, and decoder, and it decode the complex the encoded data into the back to the origin data. This is the versional autoencoder. And another model also very popular is the GAN. The GAN it means that there are in the network there are some discriminator, and it assess and it audit the quality of the generative model. So therefore, in this hierarchy of the general models, there are three popular models. This is the Bissell recurrent neural network variation. There are Bissell recurrent neural network, variational autoencoder, and GAN. And this custom model of general models is the copyright adapted from the Ian Goodfellow. This is a very popular, a very famous scientist about the digital generative model. And now, in education, generative AI is more than potential, not only tutorial and helper application, but also reality application to create new solution, new puzzle, new game learning method, In order to illustrate an application of digital generative AI model, in the next slide, there is a dragon, a tiger, along with a background of bamboo tree generative AI application. This is the digital generative AI can generate orbit or moving shortness of the dragon. And not in the next slide is the illustration of movement, which is not used its generation yet. And you see that this is the orbit of the dragon and the tiger. But however, indeed the generative AI application need to know some basic orbit of the dragon and the tiger in the next slide, in the next feature, to estimate the variance of their orbit. Moreover, as you see, the bamboo background is not changed much, and some swallow are flying happily, healthily, and freely. Of course, the number of the swallow, this is a swallow, is more than two or three. And you see that. This is the orbit of the dragon. Of course, you knew almost what I meant, but mainly mentioned here, from the digital generative AI model to issue of education and society. There are differences between ideas, talk, culture, opinion, and viewpoints, as well as the difference between natural science and social science. But these differences are not clear, and there are shifts and transformations among them, like the dragon orbit. However, the fact that there are too many events in technology as well as in society, and both it cause a blind spot, the strategic blind spot, which is an emergent feeling that the world is changing too fast, although it indeed is changing. For instance, the world order is not changed much. It not changed much because the development of the peripheral center with Gordon Hillborn of contemporary history is coping with and obstructed by the serious problem of climate change, including global warming and environmental pollution, which implies that such development will not obey the principle history. It do not obey the principle history. But we can think that the history is like the physics, Newton physics, and Einstein physics. The history will be to have a new principle. The new principle may be the extent of the old principle, but it is not the old principle. And I don't know exactly what is the new principle of the history, but I think that the development of peripheral central may not obey the principle of the old principle of the history. Of course, the growth of non-governmental organization is also very important for shaping the world order. And in our work now, in our situation, the non-government organization is more and more important day and after day. The dragon to fly into the universe. The economical deadline of some superpowers hide their efforts to improve other values about humanity, like equality, self-power, etc. In other words, their powers are not decreased actually or seriously indeed. Protectionism is dominating. Liberalism after its decay. Why? However, while everyone is making efforts about the anti-protectionism, one of McCarthy is the climate change too. And therefore, the idea of exploiting outer space resources, migrating to other planets is great, which will solve the many problems, as liberate power and creating it again. In other words, the current is flying into the universe. And this is the idea of the exploring outer space resort. And it's necessary to establish a new solar system. And some old concepts such as the colony, colony, the conqueror, something like that, some old concept will be renewed or will be changed into the new system law. Because such concept make travel can make you travel. Because in our history, we already overcome some not good thing. But when we start in the outer space resource, it will be have a new system law, so that people or nation can share the resort, or can take advantage of resort without a conflict, or maybe the conflict can be exit in the new situation, like the competition in the business, something like that. But in the other world, in this speech, I just mentioned about the Kraken is flying into the universe. And now, the Kraken is to fly back home. On the other hand, the world becomes narrower, and so the university is moving back home, so that everyone can study himself or herself with spark of AI, and so the education and lifelong study will be changed in action, and something like that in here, I mentioned that your home can be your university. Yeah, your home can be your university, because you can buy the spark of AI. For example, spark the ChatGPT, spark of the virtual environment, augmented environment, virtuality. You can study themselves, and you can observe, and you can obtain many new knowledge, and you can train yourself. And it means that the education, the lifelong study, will be changed in action. And therefore, the current is flying back home, whereas the current is flying into the universe too. And it means that it is the condition. And what is happening? The answer is that the Earth is the center of universe in the near future. In the near future, I emphasize in the near future, at least not the sun, as in the Bible, as in the Bible. Again, climate change and its related problems such as green development and intelligent society are the center of everything. And so, therefore, there may be a doom in mankind world, but such doom is too far away from now, for only the current decision maker to worry about it. I focus on the current decision maker to worry about it, and maybe there can be some transformation, and maybe it's the nature transformation and migration in the far future. However, difficulty and disaster are avoided, and it means that the climate change is serious, and in the long term, and in some cases, it is difficult to reversible. But in the finance system, finance research, the work of every nation cope with the finance research. It's very near, and very immediate. Emotion, hurry up. But you can solve. And nation. All nation can solve the problem of financial crisis. But solve the by the some policy of the state. Some policy of the state bank, but the problem of climate change seriously and much more difficult to solve. To solve the climate change. And how to fight the enemy? As aforementioned. Climate change is a negative problem needing to be solved, especially narrowing the serious gap between the poor and the rich. But one of its positive best is that some superpowers are waiting for all the superpowers to reach some goals. To reach some goals. Of course, such waiting is unexpected. However, the most important positive factor of the climate change problem is that climate change either can move up all nations to overcome obstacles, as well as develop our civilization and humanities as well as possible. In other words, climate change is a common enemy we must recognize and fight for peace. Of course, such enemies is the similarities enemy. Dear sir, madam, lady, gentlemen, professor, researcher, and everyone here. Thank you very much for your listening. I am very honored and happy to answer your question. Many thanks all of you again.